Good morning from Seoul. First thing we're gonna do is go to 7-Eleven. It's my first day in Seoul. I crashed last night. I flew in last night. Let's check out the neighborhood. Seems as though the 7-Elevens are closed. I don't know why the door is closed, locked. They should be open 24 hours. I'm not quite sure what the hell is going on there. Gonna check out the shrine, I guess, as we wait for the convenience stores to open up. Like they're waiting for the shrine to open or something? I'm not quite sure. Check out this 7-Eleven. It's open. just entered into the shrine. Apparently it opens around 8 o'clock a.m. Who's this guy? The Proclamation of Korean Independence. Bronze statue for patriot. I'm not gonna try to pronounce that name. I'm sure this place would look really cool at night. Pavilion of Topgol Park. Beautiful artwork. Some more monuments. Looks like from the Korean War. We're at the biggest Samsung store in Hongdae, Seoul. We're gonna take a look inside.
Hi.
Saw the Korean soldiers right there. So I went inside and asked them if they had S-23 cases, because I thought they had like some special cases at this place, but apparently not. So I guess I'll go find something to eat maybe. An amazing mall. I just have to make a video about it. Got trees everywhere.
You can follow in the footsteps of Seoul's transformation into a modern city, beginning with Kunjongjun Hall at Gyeongbokgung Palace, built during the Joseon Dynasty, and onto Hwanghwamun Street and the Han River during the early modern times. Not only that, you can watch how Lotte World Tower was built as well.
Thank you. Thank you. pretty cool. U.S. Army. This one is huge. I am the captain now.
Perfect way to end the night, eating ramen by the sea at night with a beer.